Hi guys, Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive. Welcome to this Marcus Mumford tech session brought to you by our friends at Elixir Strings. Now, today we're going to be focusing our attention on Marcus Mumford's acoustic playing and songwriting, the sort of which you'd find in Mumford and Sons. We're not going to be delving into his electric playing or his songwriting for other people or for TV shows, etc. So this is going to be very accessible for beginner guitar players, but it also gives us a little bit of insight into some of the odd time and odd meter stuff that Marcus tends to slip into his songs somewhat unnoticed. Sounds really cool. We're going to begin with our intro, and we're going to be doing some cowboy chords for this. Our intro is going to sound thus. So while the actual chords we're playing here are relatively simple, we are going to be doing some odd meter stuff, because this is a 7-bar phrase, which is quite interesting and not something that you hear all that commonly. We're going to begin with an E minor, which is the 2nd fret on the A string and the D string, strumming all of the strings, which we'll count for 4 as 1, 2, 3, 4. We're then going to strum for 2 beats on a D chord, which is 2nd fret G string, 3rd fret B string, 2nd fret high E, with our thumb on the 2nd fret of the low E. We're going to count this for 2 counts, like this. 1, 2. So we have 4 counts on E minor, 2 counts on D with the F sharp in the bass. We'll then go to a G chord, which will be low E fret number 3, A string fret number 2, D fret number 3, and high E fret number 3. We're going to count this for 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. 8 in total, like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Once we've done that, we'll do the same thing again, but we'll count 4 on a C add 9, which is going to be 3rd fret on the A string, 2nd fret on the D string, 3rd fret on the B string, 3rd fret on the high E. That's for 4 counts, like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. We'll keep our 3rd and 4th fingers down on the 3rd fret on the B string, 3rd fret on the high E string, and we'll replace our 1st and 2nd fingers with just the 1st finger on fret number 2 on the A string. This is going to be a G over B. It's a G chord with a B in the bass. There's our B. We're going to play this for 2 counts, like this. 1, 2. From there, we'll go back to our E minor for 2 lots of 4 counts, like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So each one of these phrases is 7 bars of 2 in length. Now that's really interesting. It's something that we hear quite a lot in Marcus's songwriting. We'll be strumming this pattern for our chorus a little bit later on, but for the intro, we play it 2 times round. Once again, it is 4 counts on the E minor, 2 counts on D, and then 2 lots of 4 on G, followed by 4 counts on C add 9, 2 counts on G over B, and then 2 lots of 4 counts on E minor. Next up, let's move to the verse, which is going to sound like this. Now let's begin by establishing the strumming pattern we're going to use, which is a pattern that we're going to use most of the way through this song. So the way we're going to do it is we're going to strike the lower strings. It can be just the lowest E string on its own, or the lowest 2 or the lowest 3 strings. Doesn't actually matter. You don't have to be too precise with this. Just think about hitting some low strings and then contrast that against some high strings. It might be the D string down over. It might be the highest 3 strings. As long as we have a distinct contrast between low and high. And that's going to be true on all of the chords we're going to be playing. So we're going to begin by strumming low, high, low, high, low, high, low, high, which you might do like this. Now, in amongst that, I explored a number of strumming strategies where we play down, down, up, down, or we play down, 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 up. Whatever works for you and helps you keep rhythm is absolutely fine. My personal preferred strategy is to go down, down, up, down, 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 up, down, but that's just me. Now, the way we're gonna begin this is by playing that strumming pattern one time through on our E minor, followed by low, high on E minor, and low, high on that D with an F sharp in the bass from before, which will give us this. From there, we're moving to G, where we play one full repetition of our strumming pattern, followed by low high on G, and then low high on G over B. For this, make sure you try and strike the A string, like this. So the first half of our verse will go together like this. From here, we're going to move to another odd time device, and this is going to be a bar of 3-2. So instead of counting it 1-2-1-2, we'll count it as 1-2-3. This is something that's going to crop up a lot in this tech session, and it's a really common device in some folk styles and something that Marcus draws on in his songwriting quite a lot. We're going to begin with the C add 9 chord. Quick reminder, that's going to be fret 3 on the A string, which is where we're going to strike our low notes. Fret 2 on the D string, fret 3 on the B string, fret 3 on the high E. We're going to play low, high, low, high, high, like this. And to fill the rest of our bar, we're going to play 3, 2 on our low E string as single notes, like this. And that's going to be followed by 2 full repetitions of our strumming pattern on E minor, like this. So altogether, our verse pattern sounds like this. It goes 4 times through, but I'll play it 1 time through for you. It's going to sound like this. Next, we're going to move to a typical pre-chorus, and this uses a contrast of a 3-2 bar against 2-2 bars. So we'd count it as 1-2-3-1-2-1-2. The way we're going to get that is beginning with our C add 9 once again. We're going to play C add 9 with a low high, low high high, and then low high on our G over B. Remind us of those chords. It's going to be 3 on the A string, 2 on the D string, then 3 and 3 on the B and high E. We'll then switch to 2 on the A string and 3 and 3 on the B and high E, like this. From there, it's 2 full repetitions of our strumming pattern on E minor, which gives us this. Next up, we're back to our C add 9, and we're doing the same thing as before, but instead of going to a G over B, we're going to that D over F sharp instead. So it's low high, low high high on our C add 9, and then low high on our D, making sure to strike the low E string as the low note on our D, like this. Now this will bring us to our G chord, where we'll play 1 full repetition of the strumming pattern, and then low high on G, low high on G over B, like this. So altogether, that version of our pre-chorus sounds like this. Next up, we're back to a similar pattern to our verse, where we're going to play C add 9 for low high, low high high, and then 3-2 on the low E string, like this. And that's followed by 2 full repetitions of our E minor strumming pattern, which will give us this. And that's going to lead us to 4 strumming patterns around a D chord, but this time we're not playing the F sharp and the bass. So our low notes are going to be the open A and open D string. Now we'll count this as 1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2, and on the 3rd bar of 2, we're going to place our 4th finger on the high E string on the 3rd fret to create a D sus 4. The strumming pattern will be low high, low high high. So watch out for that 3rd bar where I put my 4th finger down, like this. And that brings us to our chorus, which will have the same chord progression as the intro, but this time we're going to play it with a slightly different arrangement. We're going to begin with a single short strum of E minor, followed by 5 hits with the heel of your hand on the guitar's body, in time with the bass drum, which will give us this. And from here, we're back to our strumming pattern on G, but we're going to pick it up with our thumb on the low E string on fret number 2, just as a little bit of a lead in. So that's going to come before the strumming pattern. We'll play that, and then we'll play our low high strumming pattern 4 times on G, like this. Mm-hmm. From here, it's very similar pattern, but we're starting on C add 9 with a single staccato strum, followed by 4 hits on the guitar's body, and then 3, 2, a single note on the low E string, like this. And that'll take us into 4 full repetitions of our strumming pattern on E minor, which is low, high, low, high, low, high, low, high, like this. Now from here, we go back to our chords from the intro, but this time with the strumming pattern. So what we're gonna get is E minor for 2 full strumming patterns, D with the F sharp and the bass for 1 full strumming pattern, and then G for 4 full strumming patterns like this. Followed by C add 9 for 2 full strumming patterns, G over B for 1 full strumming pattern, and then E minor for 4 full strumming patterns like this. And then it's one more time back around our intro, exactly the same, where we play E minor for a 4 count, we play D over F sharp for a 2 count, and G for 2 full 4 counts like this. 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Followed by C add 9 for a 4 count, G over D for a 2 count, and then we finish with a single strum on E minor like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1. So there you go, guys, that's been a look at some of the songwriting ideas and chord playing ideas used by Marcus Mumford in Mumford & Sons. Now, Marcus is a very accomplished musician with many strings to his bow, but I did want to take a quick look at some of this beginner-focused, kind of easy cowboy chord stuff. It's quite easy to play, but because there's some very interesting songwriting ideas to be had here, I think it's something that's going to be useful for you as a songwriter going forward, and it's going to help put you in the mind of Marcus Mumford, the songwriter. So once again, this has been a look at the techniques, songwriting styles, and chord playing of Marcus Mumford of Mumford & Sons, brought to you by Elixir Strings. My name is Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine. I'll see you next time.